Today I'm gonna be showing you how to set up the master mod of Gran Turismo 5. This mod brings several features into the game, from quality of life upgrades to hidden modes. Some of the things included here are the PlayStation 2 Gran Turismo tracks. Almost every one of them are here. There are 42 of them. A Q&A menu that allows you to edit your save in-game by unlocking not only DLC, but also cars and events early. There's a course maker setting that was hidden until now, allowing you to customize track settings to your liking. There's a race editor as well. These are just some of the things available. The full list is on the GT Planet thread where this mod was first released. For those of you who watched my video on how to set up Gran Turismo 5 on PC and you have the game with you, I would recommend that you create a new RPCS3 folder and do the full configuration again just for this master mod, because it can break stuff on the original game even during the installation process. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. We'll begin by downloading RPCS3, the PS3 emulator. I'll put the link down below. And here on the main page, you just have to click here on the download button, and then you download the emulator for the operational system you're using. In my case, I'm using Windows, so I'm gonna click on this one and then place it on the folder of your preference on your PC. It will come as a zipped file, so you have to extract it with either WinRAR or 7-zip. In my case, I'm using 7-zip, so I'm just gonna extract the file here. And you can go ahead and delete the original one. We're not going to need that anymore. And to begin, you just have to double click here on rpcs3.ex to start the installation. And here there's a few options if you want to create a desktop shortcut and stuff. I would not recommend using the dark theme yet, so I'm going to turn this off. And then just click here on do not show again, and I have read the quick start guide. And then just select here on continue. And there you go. We have RPCS3 on our computer. First, we have to install the PS3 firmware on the emulator, and we can get that on the official Sony website. This is the place right here. The link will be down below. And on this page, you want to scroll down here to the bottom a little bit, and where it says how to update PS3 system software, you want to click here on update using a computer. And then you just click on download PS3 update and place the file on the same emulator folder. If for some reason the download doesn't start when you click on it, then you have to click on it with the right button on your mouse and then select copy link address and then paste the link on your browser and press enter. Then the download will start. Now back on the emulator folder, I already downloaded my firmware here. It is this file, the PS3 update. Now you want to go to the emulator and right here, click on file and click on install firmware. It should open the emulator folder by default, so now you just have to double click here on the PS3 update and it will install the firmware on RPCS3. Click here on do not show again and then click OK, and now it will install these PPU modules, but this shouldn't take long. And while you wait for it to finish, this will be a good time to subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. I would really appreciate it. Now back on the emulator folder, you're gonna see that there's this folder here called games that was already created when you installed the emulator. And this is where you're gonna be placing the game. And you can do this by dumping your own copy of the game or finding it online. But this is something that I can't show here on the video or even mention it because it's against YouTube's policy. So when you have the game with you, you just have to extract it from the zip file, and inside you're gonna have something similar to this one. So leave it like this. Now go back to the emulator and you're gonna click here on file and then click on add games. It should open the emulator folder by default. So you're gonna double click on the games folder and then click once on the Gran Turismo 5 folder and then click here on select folder. And just like that, the game will appear here on the emulator. However, this is the vanilla version of the game. We don't have the patches yet. And luckily, there is an easy way to update your games on RPCS3. Using this tool right here, Rusty PSN, the link will be down below as well. So here on this page, you just want to click here on the latest release available. It is version 3.7. And then just scroll down here to the bottom and you have to download this file right here, the rustypsn-ege-windows.zip. Download this file if you are using Windows like I am. you can place it on the same emulator folder. Now back on the RPCS3 folder, the file is right here, the Rusty PSN that is, so you just have to extract the single .ex file that is inside of it with either WinRAR or 7-zip here. And then now you just have to double click here on the rustypsn.ex and the tool will open. Before you start downloading the patches, I want you to click here on this little gear so you can change the download location for the patches. In my case, I like to create a new folder on the emulator folder here called updates, just so that I can keep things organized, you know? And now go back to rustypsn and then select pick folder, and then select that one updates folder that we just created. Remember, this is optional. This is up to you how you want to download this, but I like doing it like this. So now click here on save settings. Now to download the updates with RustyPSN, we're gonna need the game's serial code, and we can get that on the emulator right here on the game, this serial right here. So you're gonna click on the game with the right button and then select the option from the bottom that says copy info. You're gonna click here on copy serial. Now go back to RustyPSN and you're just gonna paste the code right here and then click on search for updates. And it's going to list all the updates for Gran Turismo 5. And for the master mod to work, this game needs to be updated all the way to version 2.11. So starting here from the beginning, you're going to download every patch like this all the way to version 2.11. You're gonna click on each one of them, make sure you get everything, and then just wait for the download to finish. Now go back to the emulator and you're gonna click on file again. This time click here on install packages. It should open the emulator folder by default. Double click on that updates folder we created. Inside there's a folder with the serial code of the game and inside all the updates we got. And to install them is very straightforward. You just have to highlight everything. Just press and hold the left button on your mouse, select everything like this, and then click on open. And here it's going to list all the updates you want to install. Make sure everything is in order here, like they should be, and then go ahead and click on install. Now wait for it to finish. This should only take a minute or so. Now let's configure the emulator settings for Gran Turismo 5. First, I want you to click here on config. Just open this window and then close it down. And then I want you to go to the emulator root folder, this one right here. And there's this folder called geekconfigs. Double click on it. And inside there's going to be this file here, currentsettings.ini. You can open this with the default notepad from Windows or the one that you like using. In my case, I'm going to use the default one. So click on it with the right button and then click here on open with, and then select notepad. If it's not available, you want to click here on choose another app, then select the notepad from it. So you're going to click on notepad, and inside this file, here on the meta section, there's this option here that says show debug tab equals false. You're going to erase this, delete the false from it, and replace it with true. That way we have enabled the debug tab on the emulator. So don't forget to save, click here on save, and click here, or you can press Ctrl S on your keyboard, and you can now go back to the emulator. If you had this open, close it down so that it updates. Reopen the emulator again. Now you click on the game with the right button and then select here, create custom configuration. Here on the CPU tab for the SPU decoder, ideally you want to play this game with the default one, the LLVM recompiler. But if you have an issue where the game crashes when you buy a used car, you're going to come back here and change this one to the recompiler ASMJIT. But only change this one if this issue is happening with you, because this recompiler here can introduce some glitches to your game. So I'm gonna leave mine at default. And another issue that this game could have is the audio cutting out during gameplay. If that's happening and it's bothering you, you can fix that by changing the XPU XFloat accuracy to accurate. But only change this one if this issue is really bothering you, because setting this to accurate will affect the performance of your game. So in my case, I'll leave mine at approximate and hope that doesn't happen. Finally, on SPU block size, you're gonna change this one from safe to mega. Now head over to the GPU tab and on render, make sure that Vulkan is selected here. But if your GPU is outdated, you're only gonna have OpenGL available, in which the performance will be much worse. You're gonna have a lot of stutters on OpenGL, so make sure that Vulkan is selected if that's your case. You can change the anisotropic filter from auto to 16x. This will make the game look better and has minimal impact on performance. And here on the resolution scale, do not change from 100% because this can make the game crash. So keep this one at 100% and also do not change the default resolution as well. Now head over to the Advanced tab. And here you're gonna enable the accurate RSX reservation access, and you're gonna change the RSX FIFO accuracy from fast to atomic. Finally, you're gonna go to the debug tab right here, and you're gonna click on disable Zico occlusion carries. Now we are finished here, so go ahead and click on apply and then save custom configuration. Next, let's configure the controller. Click here on pads. And this emulator has an automatic mapping function. So if you already have your controller plugged in, you want to click here on handlers and select the device you're using. In my case, I'm using a Xbox controller. So if I click here on X input, it's already going to do the configuration for me. You can use your keyboard as well, if that's what you want to do. And you can remap individual buttons as well. When you're done, you can click here on save to close this down. And now let's install the master mod itself. So like I mentioned before, the master mod is available here in this thread on the GT Planet forum. And here you can see all the changes that this mod brings into the game, all the quality of life upgrades and everything. And here on this install and download section, you want to click here on this link. And inside, you're gonna click on the latest. And here you can see that we have four different versions for this mod. It's the same mod, but it's made for each region of the game. And in my case, I have the American version of Gran Turismo 5. You can check that on the emulator right here by the serial code. See, it's the one that ends with this number. So for the mod to work in my emulator, I have to get the American version, of course. So depending on what region of the game you have with you, you have to get the mod from the same region. So go ahead and download the mod and place it on the folder of your preference on your PC. In my case, I downloaded the mod into the same games folder on the emulator, and you're gonna need either WinRAR or 7-zip to extract this one. I have 7-zip, so I'm just gonna double click on it like this, and we're gonna have a bunch of files in here. And the one that we are interested here is this PDIPFS file right here. So double click on it. We're gonna need these two folders right here. They have the mod files. So I'm gonna leave this open. And now you're gonna go back to the emulator root folder. Make sure the emulator is closed, by the way, so we don't get any errors here. Now, you're gonna double click here on this dev HDD0 folder. Double click on the game folder. Then double click on the folder that has the serial code of your Gran Turismo 5. This is the one for me. Now inside, double click on this USR DIR folder, and then double click on the PDI folder, this one right here. So now you're gonna move the files from the zip folder, these two folders right here, into this folder. So go ahead and select both of them, just click drag and drop them like this, or the way just you normally like to, and then wait for it to move. It's going to ask if you want to replace this one right here. Go ahead and click on replace the file in destination and just wait for it to finish. Since we are moving a bunch of files, your Windows will likely freeze like it is happening for me right now. Don't worry, this is normal. You can click away like this. Just close this folder down. You'll probably get an error like this one. Don't worry, the mod is already there. You can close this. And now on the emulator folder, run the emulator once again, and we are ready to start the game. So just double click on it. When you start, it's going to ask if you want to install this package. Click on no. Not sure why the game is asking us that. And there you go. Now you just have to wait until the game compiles these PPU modules. This one should only take a few minutes, depending on how strong your CPU is. And the game is ready to go, and you can start playing the master mod of Gran Turismo 5. I have many videos like this on the channel covering how to install and play games on PC. So if you like what you saw, don't forget to check out my other stuff. subscribe to the channel, and also leave a like on this video. Thank you for watching, and as always, I'll see you soon.